As promised, we are back with a video demonstrating the solution on how to troubleshoot a difficult radial arterial line placement after repeated failure. Thank you to all of you who have invested your time to watch the last video and shared your tips and tricks on how to troubleshoot this clinical challenge. Now, the comments on the video are extremely valuable, and I have given it a lot of consideration and using many of them in our own practice and when teaching younger colleagues. I particularly love the comment by one viewer who said, "I love when videos actually show the mistakes. I feel that most people learn so much more from seeing the mistakes rather than they do from seeing something that goes flawlessly." And that is so true. And I strongly encourage you to record a video of yourself doing a radial arterial line or any other procedure and review. In these videos, we are all likely to find that our own techniques are not as impeccable as we thought they were, and they could be improved by watching these videos. In fact, at NYSORA, we routinely record many procedures daily for the purpose of the critical review later. Very rarely do we find that our procedures are flawless or impeccable. Have you ever wondered how is it possible that the authors in various articles in ultrasound-guided regional anesthesia journals or regional anesthesia textbooks look so amazing? As an author of some of those articles and regional anesthesia textbooks, and from the feedback by other authors, I know that we all take multiple takes, dozens of images and videos before selecting the one to feature in our publications, and even then we actually edit them using Photoshop or many other digital editing tools to make them look better than what you normally get on ultrasound screen. As you remember from the last video, several attempts at anatomy-based radial line cannulation failed. We were able to obtain arterial blood flow, but we were not able to insert the catheter and get adequate arterial waveform.
We see. So we switching now to ultrasound. Yeah, let's see what we see. So clearly the artery is right there. Okay, so what we see also is the artery, if you can apply less pressure a little bit, so the artery opens up, but it's spastic. You can clearly see the spasm of the artery and a little bit of the periarterial hematoma. So let's scan a little bit higher up. More proximal, and that's the artery. Now you're back to the normal lumen away from the site where it's laser spastics. So we can give some more local anesthetic on both sides. This is exactly what we want. So this prevents the arterial spasm. Good. Okay. And now you're ready. Good. Just leave it, let it be. Now what you want actually maybe a little bit of gauze, so when you get bleeding, flush back so you can stop it. There you go. So it's out of plane technique, and let's take a look at it on the ultrasound. Okay, so there we go. We're almost on the artery. Now we want to advance fast to get into the artery. And there we go. Okay. We have a flashback. Yes. Good. That's exactly what we want. Pass the guide wire.
Too long.
I'll bring a self-saver in the meantime. There we go. So the wire is in. We now withdraw the needle, leaving the catheter inside. The guide wire inside, that is. Good. Okay. Slowly. Let me see the end of the catheter here. Good. Keep going. We're looking for the wire coming out of the end of the catheter. There we go. And now we advance everything, let me see it, everything as a unit. Okay. Okay, it's not the prettiest, but it works very well. going to attach. The adhesive dressing. Good.
Getting it empty.
And that was it. I hope this was instructional, and feel free to post your comments, questions, and suggestions on what you would do in this clinical scenario. Would you switch to guide wire immediately? Or would you use ultrasound to guide the catheter insertion while monitoring real time? Or would you combine the two? Hope you enjoyed the video, and be sure to subscribe so you don't miss the future ones. Greetings.